All right, guys, so one of the questions that still commonly comes up is how do I replicate some of these OEM sound deadeners? Some of them have textures, some of them have shapes, some of them have lines. What is it exactly that we're doing to replicate that? We've got a few new techniques that we want to show you here, and we're going to use two different products to represent this. We're going to start first with our NVH dampening material. As with all of our cartridges, we will want to make sure that we're going to equalize it first, always in an upright position and into a paper towel, making sure that we got equal parts of A and B coming out of the cartridge before we put on our static mixing nozzle. Once the nozzle is on and the ring is locked down, we want to dispense about 2 or 3 inches of material, just making sure that it's equally mixed before we start applying it to the vehicle. So now in this application here, I want to get enough material out here, and then I'm going to knock it flat before we're going to try to replicate the OEM bead. When I do this, I'm going to keep the tip buried in the wet material as I'm going back and forth so that I'm not entering air into this. And all I'm trying to do here is just get a large volume of material out. Now this NVH is a two-part urethane. It is highly flexible. It has a longer work window than some of our other two-part products, so if you're doing a larger area, this might be your product of choice. So for this application here today, we're going to replicate that drawn-in line look, right? Some of you guys may have come across this. And what we found is the best, after we've applied our material to the surface and we've knocked it down flat, again, pushing it to the surface, making sure we got a nice tight seal, we're going to take a mud spreader here. And I've actually used a pinking shears to put in this look and appearance so that we've got that consistent OEM factory look. And once we've got it flattened out, all I'm going to do is just add that style and feature into the product by dragging it over the top. Now, if you have a hardened, squared off application that you're trying to replicate, you can use tape to tape this off. If you're trying to repair a corner of a sound pad in like a trunk floor area, maybe the car was rear-ended, you can do that. Also, you can use the spreader at the end to feather it out if it has more of a natural feathered look to it. One of the other products that we can use to replicate this, if it's more of a rigid material, some of the guys have messaged us saying, I've got a really rigid sound pad, how am I going to replicate that? One of the products that we recommend for that is actually our 8308 Heavy-Bodied Seam Sealer. Again, we're going to equalize that cartridge upward into a paper towel, making sure we got equal parts of A and B. Once we apply our static mixing nozzle and we lock down the ring, we're going to dispense a little bit of material, making sure we got an equal mix. Again, I'm just trying to get material out here. We're gonna turn the applicator up a little bit. And as I'm doing this, I'm keeping the material wet on wet. I'm not allowing any gaps or voids, creating a nice tight seal to the surface so I've got no air underneath. That's important because we're gonna create good adhesion that way, and we're gonna prevent the intrusion of any moisture getting underneath. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab my spreader and I just wanna knock the material down first. Again, we're just pushing it down into that surface, making sure that I'm tape to tape because this is what I'm trying to replicate. And what we're trying to accomplish here is a textured look. So one of the ways that we're gonna do that is actually with a gray Scotch-Brite pad. And once we've got our material tooled out to the desired shape that we want, we can go ahead and we can start adding some texture. Now, depending on what you're trying to accomplish, we can go really deep or we can go really soft. It's all gonna depend on you. If you really wanna create something that's light, we can get really light, we can get really coarse, right? Some of them get kind of wild and crazy. This is just a technique. Depending on what you're trying to replicate is gonna depend on how hard or how soft you're going to push. So when it comes to sound deadening replication, hopefully these couple little tips help you. For more information on this and other seam sealers, please visit us at 3M Collision Repair Academy. Also, check out some of the other videos we got on our YouTube channel here. If you hit like and subscribe down below, and then the notification bell, you'll be up to date as we release new content, keeping you up to date on the industry's best practices and new tips and tricks. If you like this video, throw a comment in the section below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.